Sir.
It is indeed a historical day for the Bombay sappers, whose true name is Bombay Engineer Group, because they celebrate 200 years from the time they were raised. They are celebrating a major event called Bicentenary celebrations from 29th January to 1st of February at their center in Kirti. And I have the privilege that Aviation Defense Universe is conducting the interview of the Commandant of the Bombay Engineer Group, Brigadier M.J. Kumar, Simranen. Sir, it is indeed a pleasure to talk to you, because the Bombay sappers have a saga of valor, glory, sacrifice and accomplishment over this long journey of 200 years. And at this momentous occasion, you are the helm of affairs. Now, we would like to know as to what all events you have planned during this period of bicentenary.
I would like to answer that in two parts. One is the run-up itself to the bicentenary celebrations, as brought out by you, sir, from 29th of January to 1st of February, and then the bicentenary celebrations proper. So in the run-up, first we had the bicentenary motorcycle expedition. This started very auspiciously on Kargil Divas Day, on 26th of July, from Dras, where 108 Engineer Regiment had won the battle honor Dras, yes, and it was flagged off by General Hasabnes, ex-CO 108.
And Karim Chaudhary won the...
And Karim Chaudhary was the CO.
Yeah.
And after traversing 3,700 kilometers across 8 states, it was finally flagged in here in Pune by our Army Commander then, Lieutenant General Sen. That was the first expedition. Thereafter, we've had an expedition to Mount Baljuri in the Garhwal Himalayas, which had not been attempted for the last 12 years because of its degree of difficulty. This was successfully scaled by our Bombay Sappers mountaineering expedition, and the same mountaineering expedition was flagged in Delhi at Manekshaw Center by our present chief, our senior and honorary Colonel Commandant, General Naravane. Third in the row was on 5th of January this year, when we had the bicentenary marathon being conducted for the first time ever in a virgin route, I would say, in the Diggy Hills, where you know, sir,
yeah,
our training battalion 2 and associated facilities are there. Following this, as we speak today, our sailing expedition, which traversed 800 nautical miles from Mumbai to Okha in Gujarat and back, is being flagged in by Colonel Commandant at Mumbai. And tomorrow, a cycle expedition, which was flagged off by General Kindi Sharma and our present ENC from Delhi, is culminating in the Bhagat Pavilion.
And led by?
Led by General Hasabnes again.
Yes.
So this is all the events which were in terms of expeditions, which were prior to
now
the event itself.
Tell me, sir, about the events which you have planned here.
Yes. Yeah. So in the events which we have planned here, we start off with the exhilarating para drop and skydiving display on 30th morning. We'll be having for the first time aviation helicopter-based paratroopers of the Army Adventure we've also taken part, besides the paratroopers from Agra. Then we have a Bombay-based celebrity singer, a Bollywood singer entertaining us in the evening in the Bhagat Pavilion. Next morning we have got something which is completely new, a Bicentenary Heritage Walk, which will take us to certain heritage sites in our center. Now amongst them is also a group museum which I may talk about subsequently, which has been totally refurbished and renovated. Then we have a symphony orchestra for the first time ever being played out in our venerated parade ground, which the chief should be attending. And of course, the icing on the cake is the commemoration parade, which will be on first morning at our parade grounds. These are the events which have been lined up.
You talked about the expeditions. You talked about the various events which you have planned for Bicentenary. Bombay sappers are famous for their contribution towards National Building, aid to civil authority, and combat engineers, of course, United Nations missions. Tell me something in the recent past which they have done, for example, in the Bombay, when the railways were having problem of the port over bridge in Mumbai and the floods in Kerala and Maharashtra. How do you accomplish such difficult tasks with so much of precision, so much of speed and so much of josh?
We have an ideal amalgam of troops. We have 37% Marathas, 37% Ramdasya Mazhabi Sikhs, and we got 14% Muslims and other Indian castes which make up the rest. It's such an ideal amalgamation that the Marathas give us solidity, maturity to take on tasks over a longer duration of time. We got our Sikhs who can perform miracles, whether it's 24 hours or 36 hours or 48 hours, our Ramdasya Mazhabi Sikhs. And we got the Muslims who are able to give very good leadership, very solid leadership before over a period of time. And of course, the other Indian castes make up for all whatever is lacking. Now, with this kind of a base, it's no wonder we have had 37 battle honours,
yes,
pre and post independence, and 31 theatre honours.
Yes.
It's been over 200 years that we have been achieving this. We were the first ones to be conferred the title Royal, which in fact finds, when we have our logo, sir, which has now become ubiquitous everywhere, you find two C's,
yes,
with two logos inside them. The first one is about our pride of being the first ones to be conferred the title Royal. And the second one, which is under the second C, is our Bombay Sappers Memorial, which commemorates the sacrifice, the valor, and actually loss of lives of our soldiers who went to war. And that is where the blood part of it, that so much of sacrifice is taking place. And the two C's actually just are the Roman 100 and 100. So two C's make 200. One gives us pride about being conferred the title Royal, and one gives us the symbol, which is our Bombay Sapper Memorial, which started in the year 1984. So we have this ideal amalgam. Now, the recent one, I correctly brought out, some foot over bridges in Bombay, over those three railway stations, following the collapse of a foot over bridge, is very much in our memory. It was a remarkable job done with so much of precision, and the locals continued moving when this work was done. It is, I would not like to crow much more about it, it's well known, but we were summoned and we were very successful. Subsequently, in Kerala floods, which were unique floods of their own time, so there, again, the role of the Bombay Sappers was laudatory. In the recent times, unheard of floods took place in Sangli and Kolhapur districts. Never been affected by floods before. And now, good 5 months, 4 months after that, we continue to receive congratulatory and laudatory messages from the local populace, from the people who have a lot of interest, abiding interest in that area, and from Maharashtra at large, about our role which we played there. I would like to mention that on Raksha Bandhan Day, we were to come back, and on that day, all the flood affected people in spite of whatever situation they were in, the way they saw us off, the farewell that they gave us was actually very beautiful. It has inspired us, it continued to motivate us to do anything in terms of 8 to September 13 times to come.
I think Bombay Sappers truly deserve this accolade and tribute. Our hats off to the Bombay Sappers, their courage, their forethought, their wisdom and their leadership. So you are at the helm of affairs at the time when Bicentenary is celebrated, and you are also the Commandant of the Bombay Sappers and responsible for the training of the boys who do so well in various fields of sports. How do you train them, how do you identify them, how do you motivate them to have such accomplishments?
Sir, as brought out by you, we have had a very fabulous track record as far as sports and adventure goes. 7 Arjuna Awards themselves speak. We have had any number of people who have taken part in Commonwealth Games, in Asian Games and in Olympics. Just to elaborate on this, we have been at the forefront of sailing, rowing, we've been at the forefront of boxing, athletics. Even as of today, we have been and are continuing to be at the forefront of these sports. But we have not left any other field, whether you talk of golf, cricket, football, hockey. Incidentally, the Indian hockey team goalkeeper, Karkara, is ours now for 3 years running. And if you take it, there's no field of sports which we have not touched, and with excellence. About adventure, I've already summed up. So on sports, when we have such a legacy, and we are today handling 22 disciplines in our center, we have, without any doubt, anybody would have made us centers of excellence for various. So we are centers of excellence for gymnastics, for rowing, and we have a scheme for the boys sports company, which is but a subset of the National Youth Talent Scheme, in which we are funded partially by SAI, and that helps us get very young talent. On top of it, our ex-erstwhile sportsmen, for instance, the SP of Ropal today, is our twice Asian Games medalist, Jagjit Singh. All these people who are ex-Bombay Sappers, wherever they are in the country, they are such staunch Bombay Sappers. As we say, once a Bombay Sapper, always a Bombay Sapper.
Yes.
They have never fallen short of contributing to our sports talent. Once we have talent, we can always hold them, because there has been a culture of nurturing excellence in our center. We really hope to continue to maintain doing this well at the national and international levels. The number of medals we have won in the last 3 years at even international levels speaks volume about our prowess as Bombay Sappers in sports.
Will Bombay Sappers get more and more royals, laurels under command? In the end, sir, since we are having Bicentenary celebration, all the eyes of the Bombay Sappers, officers, Sardar Sahan and Jawans is on the center, and the nation also as such. What message would you like to give to the younger generations?
A long duration, Bombay Sappers have never failed in any task. This excellence, this tradition by our predecessors like you and others is such a motivation for the younger generations, people like us and people who are following me. We must look back at all our forefathers who brought such a legacy onto us, and we should continue to excel whether in combat or peacetime activities And we should continue to also extend our excellence in sports adventure activities and aid to civil authorities, all the fields which have been touched by you today. This is what I would exhort all Bombay sappers to look in the future and lead us to further glory. I wish all the Bombay sappers, all ranks and their families, all the very best for this bicentenary celebrations and beyond.
Thank you, sir. We were listening to a very exhaustive and educative talk by Brigadier Kumar, the Commandant of the Bombay Sappers, at the time when the bicentenary celebration is being celebrated by the Bombay Sappers. We are grateful to you, sir, and wish that this particular celebration would be become a sort of beacon for the people to come for the future and emulate the thought and ideas which you have spread in this particular event. Thank you very much once again.
Thank you, sir.
Okay? Yes, sir. Abhi video le lo, chau, sabota.